Hi, everybody. I'm Blaine with the plumbing department. We're going to go over the toilet tank versus the basic components of it. I don't have a laser pointer or anything, but you've got the fill valve, which adjusts the water flow that goes in the toilet. The flow adjustment screw where you can adjust it, which on one of these valves, that's an older style valve. But on the new fill valves, it's on the right here. And you've got your fill tube, which is just where the overflow goes into the toilet bowl. On an older style toilet, there's a float. First, I'm going to show you how to replace the fill valve if it's bad. First off, turn off the water, the toilet. Usually you'll have a stop. You want to turn your stop off. And then you'll need to, a good way to test if the water is actually off is to flush the toilet after the stop is off. Flush, that means you don't have any water in there. You'll want to flush it anyway to try to get as much of the water out of it as possible after you've turned it off. And you'll unscrew the supply line here. You'll want to put a bucket or a little can or something under here to catch the water and some rags. You'll disconnect the supply line. And you'll take this nut off. The overflow tube, and then you have your flush valve. It's as simple as that to take it out of there. Better picture of it is in here. You've got your tube, goes into the overflow tube there. And with these, in order to adjust the older ones had a float like this one. This is very many of these left anymore. But that float ball there, just the water, it senses the water level, and as it goes up, it turns the water off. But the new ones has this. This is now your ball, and this goes up. And once it reaches where it's set at, it'll turn the water off. And the only way to adjust these, it's really simple, is get a Phillips screwdriver, and this just turns. Very, very simple. Just turn them. It's the easiest way to adjust it, just like that one. But, also, the trick to these, some of them, you can take this nut off. With this all in there, you don't have to even take it out. You can pull this apart. Well, this is still in the toilet. It makes it easier. You won't have to disconnect the supply line or any of that. Some of the other models, like this one, doesn't, this CERN one in here, or WDI, you can't do that to that one. This is a Fluid Master style here. Let's see, and then we have the flapper. There's a flapper here. Usually if your toilet, your tank's running, your flapper will be wore out, or the plastic will be corroded. Or with the flappers, it just has, they just sit on these two ears here. They just sit on there. You just pull them off. They come right out. You'll disconnect the chain. This flapper. This is a 3-inch flapper that's in this toilet. Really easy to take out. There isn't much to them. last we have the toilet handle. Sometimes the toilet handle gets worn out, or you just don't like the way it looks, and you want to buy one of those fancy looking ones, or any of that stuff. But this, the nut that's inside there is a left-handed thread. So you actually have to, it's righty-loosey, lefty-tighty. So get that out, take that nut out. That's about it. And with the tank's mounted to the toilet with two bolts. It's really simple. There's a gasket in between the tank and the toilet. And that's it. Is there any more slides? Okay. Yeah, if you have any questions, just ask me at the end of the presentation.
Okay, first thing I'll say is, if you're going to have to do this, you should be wearing gloves, obviously. It's a bit more simple for me to do it this way. Let's see. So, this has probably happened to everybody. We have three children at home, so we get crayons and used to be G.I. Joes. My son's a bit older now, but you would never know what we'd find these things. So if this happens and it backs up, if it were to back up, it could be, the bowl could be completely full, it could be overflowing. Hopefully it's not. If you have to deal with that, if you're able to, I know a lot of people will have a shelf or a cabinet or something above. You don't always have to turn the valve off if it's overflowing. I know he showed the flapper valve. If you have your tank lid off, you can, and your water spilling over, you can generally push that little rubber flapper down, and it'll close the throw of that off, because they will occasionally get stuck up, and you won't have any more water dumping back into the bowl to spill out. So if it's clogged and you don't have a lot of water in the bowl, it could just be toilet paper or something. You may not know what's inside. Take the plunger. You want to make sure that there's enough water in the bowl to, and you want to make sure that cup is pulled out there, just the plunger. Make sure there's enough water in the bowl to cover the majority of the plunger, because if you have just a little bit of water, one, you're really not going to get anywhere, and you don't want to splash that little bit of water out of the bowl on the counter, around the toothbrushes, in the sink. So you take your plunger, you want to tip it back, and as you put it in, allow the air to kind of, you'll see it bubble out of the water, and make sure you've got a good seal between this and the throat of that bowl. And it's just like you've seen a thousand times, you want to give it a good push, but you also kind of want to pull back sharply. You don't want to just push air through, because when it makes the vacuum, you're just as likely to pull something out as you are to push it through. So you take the plunger, tilt it back, make sure you get your seal. Don't stick your hand in the water like I just did. give it a good shove and a pull back. You can go more quickly if you want. And generally you can see, it may take a few times, and you'll see that water level go down. You may clear the blockage completely, it may all go through, and you want to give it a flush or two to see if it's clear. Most of the time you'll know. If it seems like it's mostly clear, you may get a bit of toilet paper, just small particles back. There may be something else small stuck in the throat or at the bottom near the flange. If it doesn't clear, and it could still be full, it could be that you plunge most of it out and there's just a little bit left and it seems like there may be something stuck. You can use an auger. This is a new one, so it's nice and clean, so I can touch the cable with my bare hands. You see the bulb on the end, it's got that sort of a short thing there. And you see the sort of sleeve on the end of this, that curved peg there will allow it to go in the throat. throat fall to shake the toilet, and it will hopefully protect the bowl as well. And there's not really necessarily anywhere for this cable to go. But if it gets to this point, you have to use the auger. You're going to have to force it in, more or less. So you're going to give it a push. Sometimes it'll go in easily, sometimes it won't. You can just spin it. And you can see how, as it goes in, how that bowl will grab toilet paper or paper towels or washcloths or whatever it may be. And it may or may not come out. It could push it through. It could come out on the end. And you can actually extend these out sometimes to go in. Some of the models will go further, and they'll go in a little bit further in the line. If that doesn't work, you can call a plumber, or if you're feeling adventurous. I know that, I guess, Blaine, he already showed you how you want to make sure the water's off. And I don't know if we're going to
turn the water off.
Yeah, make sure your water's off.
Disconnect the supply line.
Disconnect your supply line. You're going to have, make sure, hopefully you've had somewhere, you've already emptied the tank into the bowl and you won't have any water in here. If so, you'll want to have a cup or, like he said, a can or a bucket to catch it with. Lay some, maybe an old towel or something back there, because you're going to get some water. If you have to pull the toilet, it's best if you have someone to help you. Obviously, I mean, they're fairly heavy. If it comes to that, if you can keep it level, and you're lucky enough to keep it level, maybe get it outside to where you can turn it on the side to see what's underneath, you can keep most of the water. Assuming there's no water in the bowl, you'd obviously want to dip that out. Dump it wherever you want to, because you don't have a toilet to dump it into. But if you're going to have water trapped inside here, if you can keep it level, you can generally keep that water in the toilet until you can take it outside. If you have to pull it, you have your adjust 4-inch. Take the nuts off of the Johnny bolts.
Be a nut in the washer.
Nut in the washer. Remove those. Most of the time you'll have a beauty cap and a ring under there that cap would attach to. You just take those off and keep those. Sometimes you can reuse these, sometimes you have to replace them.
You won't have an invisible man standing inside the wall.
Yeah, you won't have an invisible man inside the wall. We'll just show you the underside. So if you can let them keep it level. There'll be a wax ring on here that would be squashed flat, and it may come off and be attached to the bottom of the bowl. It could all be there. It's going to be messy, and you're going to have to scrape that off and clean that up before you set the bowl back. Still, like I said, if you are able to get this outside, then you can just kind of see. Obviously, this one's new and clean. There's a possibility you can get to whatever's stuck there. And if you had pliers or needle nose pliers, channel lock, something like that, and you could pull it out, then good luck, you. And we would probably take it, when Jeff and I talked about, take it out in the yard and run water through it, try to clean it the best that we could. This is your wax ring. This is a new one. There are a couple of different styles of these. You actually want to set it. If you had to replace these, you just want to make sure that they're kind of lined up with each other. You take the wax ring. Some of these won't have this horn on the bottom, it'll just be the wax. Some people may put it on the bottom of the toilet itself. I think it's easier to do it this way. Get these where they're fairly well lined up. starts up with the hole. You see that one? Mm-hmm. So.
That's good.
And you saw the shape on the bottom of the toilet bowl there, that flange, or the wax ring will seal between the bowl and the flange, but you're going to have to put some pressure on it, kind of rock it back and forth, and you'll feel it as it seats. I don't know if that kind of wax ring and the flange on this board, it's going to sit perfectly. What happened?
It's working. It looks pretty good.
You want to, if you have, like I said, if you had the beauty caps, you'd put the beauty ring down first, your washer and your nut. And when you tighten this, you do not want to over-tighten it. That's why I'm going to stop this small wrench, because you don't want to trick yourself. If you have too large of a wrench or something like that, you may not realize you're putting as much pressure as you are. But you'll feel it as you tighten it. And you'll feel it snug up. And it'll seat itself on that wax ring. And you just want to bump it. I don't necessarily feel safe saying if you've not done it 1,000 times, because they know you can break the flange, especially if you've got an old cast iron flange. But you just want to snug it up and be able to tell that it's not rocking, that everything's good and sturdy. Put your beauty caps on, reattach your supply line, turn the water back on.
Water on. You'll have to wait until when you flush it, you'll tell it if the gasket's leaking.
Yeah, that's going to test your seal. Those generally seal fairly easily. But you have to flush, and hopefully it flushes through. If not, call Jeff Miller.